Praise the Lord. I'm Sharon Hardy Knotts with Salem Network with the word of the Lord. 1 Timothy 4:1. The Spirit speaks distinctly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of demons. The word depart means to take a stand away from, to desert. And the word seduce means to lead into error, to deceive, and to corrupt. And we are seeing seduction that leads to desertion. We're hearing of many prominent leaders in the body of Christ who are now renouncing their faith in Christianity. But we should not be shook up by these things or surprised, for they are a fulfillment of Scripture. Jesus told us in the parable of the vine that he is the vine and his Father is the vine dresser. And every branch that bears not fruit, he said, it shall be taken away. The key is to remain in him and his words to remain in us. These are the branches that will remain while the others that become unfruitful will be taken away. This coincides with the parable of the sower, which Jesus said is the key to all parables. And in this parable, there were four grounds. The first two grounds immediately gave up, but the third ground went on to bring forth fruit. But Jesus said they became unfruitful. And the thing was, the thorns and thistles rose up and choked out their good fruit. And he identified these as being the cares of this life and the deceitfulness and lust for riches and the pleasures of this life. They became unfruitful. That means out of four grounds, only one, the fourth ground, made it. One out of four. That's only 25% that made it. That means 75% did not remain, and they were taken out of the way. I want to read to you a very powerful and significant verse in Hebrews, the 12th chapter. And I'm looking at verse 26, the second part. Yet once more, I shake not the earth only, but also the heaven. And this word, yet once more, signifies the removing of those things that are shaken, as of the things that are made, that those things which cannot be shaken may remain. So we are seeing here that God said, I am going to shake the heaven and the earth. And when God shakes, things are going to be removed. But he said, the significance is not so that we can look at those who are shaken out of the way and say, well, they're hypocrites. Look at them. They got shaken out of the way. The purpose in God's mind is to remove them out of the way so that those who cannot be shaken shall remain. So don't get shook up about the shakeup. Do what Jesus says and remain in him, and his words remain in you, and you will not be shaken out. Till next time, this is Sharon saying, Maranatha.